Today we'll use defocus to spice up a normal, everyday shot. Here's a photo taken by one of the photographers that I follow on Flickr. It was shot with an original iPhone, so the quality of the shot isn't that great. And this is what I came up with after some creative editing in Facetune. Although I used a little bit of reshaping and changed the color grading, defocus is really what brings this image to life. Accurately applying varying degrees of defocus can really help even with the most mundane images. And for me, it's hard to imagine anything more mundane than a keyboard. Let's start by reshuffling the letters with patch. I'll fast forward through this part just a little bit. Now, let's crop it to Instagram square format. In order to do an accurate defocus, I'll start by blurring the entire image. Now, let's remove the effect from the areas that we want to keep in focus. With Facetune, you can be extremely accurate. You can zoom in to the pixel level with a pinch gesture. Okay, we're almost done here. Another small tip for today. You can use a smoother option in order to reduce the noise on some regions of the image. So, let's clean up the letters a little bit. Now, let's choose a filter to complement our result. Let's go with a silver black and white effect, dramatic lighting, and a little bit of vignetting and a simple frame. I think the result is more interesting than our original image. Defocus was definitely the key here. One last thing for today. You can find all of our tutorials in the mailbox, which you can access by clicking on the Facetune logo. Please share if you come up with any new and unexpected ways to use Facetune. We really want to hear from you. Okay, that's all for today.